हॅलो, नवयुग शिक्षण प्रसारक मंडळ चापोली, संजीवनी महाविद्यालय चापोली, ॲफिलिएटेड बाय स्वामी रामानंद तीर्थ मराठवाडा युनिव्हर्सिटी नांदेड. गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल द स्टुडंट ऑफ क्लास BSCTY, सब्जेक्ट झूलॉजी, पेपर नंबर 13A, नेम ऑफ द पेपर पिसिकल्चर, सेमिस्टर 5, युनिट नंबर 1, टॉपिक फिश फॉर इंजिनिअरिंग, प्रेझेंटेड बाय मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर थोरात मंदाकिनी मनोहर, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर अँड HOD ऑफ झूलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट. इन द लास्ट पिरियड वी सी फिश फॉर्म इंजिनिअरिंग. द जनरली फिश फॉर्म इंजिनिअरिंग इज अ कन्सिस्ट बाय 4 मोस्ट कॉम्पोनंट, लाइक द टोपोग्राफी, लाइक द सॉइल टाइप, लाइक द वॉटर सप्लाय अँड ले आउट ऑफ द फिश फॉर्म. इन द लास्ट पिरियड वी सी द डिटेल अबाउट द टोपोग्राफी अँड द सॉइल टाइप. इन दिस पिरियड वी सी द डिटेल अबाउट वॉटर सप्लाय अँड द ले आउट ऑफ द फिश फॉर्म. तर येस, टुडे वी लर्न अबाउट द वॉटर सप्लाय. तर जनरली इन द फिश फॉर्म इंजिनिअरिंग वी नो दॅट इज द वॉटर इज द इम्पॉर्टंट सोर्स फॉर द फिश प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द पॉन्ड. तर जनरली इन द वॉटर सप्लाय दे आर नेसेसरी. अवेबिलिटी ऑफ द ॲडिक्वेट सप्लाय ऑफ द वॉटर इन द सफिशंट क्वांटिटी नियर द फिश फॉर्म इज द साईन एक्वॉन इन द सलेक्शन ऑफ द साईट. द क्वालिटी अँड क्वांटिटी ऑफ वॉटर इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द फिश कल्चर डिपेंड्स अपॉन द टाईप अँड अमाऊंट ऑफ द फिश टू बी रेज्ड इन द पॉन्ड्स. सर्टन फिशेस रिक्वायर लार्ज अमाऊंट ऑफ फ्रेश अँड वेल ऑक्सिजनेटेड वॉटर while the other require less oxygen and lesser amount of the water. Thus, as related, the fish quality and quantity of water is required for the fish culture depend upon their amount of the fish they are used. A constant level of water in the fish pond and their temperature can be maintained by constructing the farm near the some source of water supply. The dependable source of water supply are the lakes and reservoir, second is the spring, third is the river, fourth is the canal, fifth is the surface runoff, and sixth is the well. So these are the different dependable source of water supply they are formed. So generally big tank, reservoir, lakes are perhaps the best source of water. Dam provide the cheapest water for the fish farm. Good spring do not dry in the summer and form the dependable source of water. Streams, rivulets and canals are also the satisfactory source provided the flow in enough to fill the ponds. A constant water level is maintained with a little silt so that fresh water is available even during the rainy season. Small streams that are likely to be the flooded during the heavy rains should be avoided because the water carries the heavy silt and reduces the fertility of the fish pond. The water of river supplied by the canals is also the satisfactory and dependable source. Very clear water is the since poor in the nutrient, it require the pre-fertilization. The muddy water has to be settled in the separate ponds before it is supplied to the fish pond. Greenish water indicate the rich food for the growth of the fish, while the brownish water indicate the acidic character of the water. The water of the latter type has been neutralized with the lime before it is supplied to the ponds. So this is the water supply. And last is the fish farming management is important for the layout of the fish pond, or it is also called the design of the fish pond. So generally, layout of the fish pond or the design of the fish pond. Generally, when we constructing the pond, the layout or the plan, layout plan have to be drawn for the location, design and the number of various types of ponds. The size of the ponds depends on the purpose of the farms. There are the two major kinds of the fish farm. In the first kind, the fish farmer procures the fry and fingerlings from the hatcheries and rears them in the farm to the marketable sizes as restricted the farming. In the second kind, a large number of ponds are built in the farm. The fish are bred, eggs are hatched, fry reared and fingerlings are raised to the marketable size. That is also called complete fish farming. The latter type of fish farming require the many ponds and an elaborate the management. So generally, the different types of the ponds we are constructed, that is the source of water supply, may also vary depending upon which they may be classified into the following types. That is the spring water pond, rainwater ponds, flood plain, oxbow ponds, well water ponds, watercourse pond, barrage pond, diversion pond. These are different types of the ponds. They supply the water. Also, distinguishing character in the terms of biological and technological character for the various category of the ponds are as follows. That is, the first is the head pond. This pond is usually constructed near a perennial source of water. The purpose of this pond is to be meet the water requirement of entire the farm, taking into the consideration the losses through the seepage and the evaporation excess, etc. These are the first pond is called head pond. Second pond is the hatching pit or the ponds. It is also called as the spanning pond. These are the small tank, usually of size is 8 multiply by 4 multiply by 2 feet, and are used for hatching the fertilized eggs. These are located near the riverine collection ground. A continuous but a slow flowing water is desirable for aerating the eggs. The tank are fixed with huppa and called hatching huppa. In the figure also we see these different types of the ponds. That is, the first is the head pond, second is the hatching fin feet or the pond. This is also called hatching huppa or the hatcheries. The tank are fixed up with the huppa called hatching huppa, made up of coarse cloth or the mosquito curtain cloth. The span is collected in the huppa where the hatching takes place. Similar type of the ponds are constructed in the fish farm or the dipper ponds with the circulating water may be utilized by fixing the huppa. In the latter case, the breeders are released into the huppa after injection of hypophysial suspension. Spanning occur within the huppa and the spent breeders are removed from it. Number of hatching ponds may be up to the 6. That is the second type is the hatching feet or the ponds. It is also called a hatching ponds. Third type is the nursery pond. These ponds are also called as a transplantation pond. This pond is also called as the transplantation pond. These are the size is the 50 × 50 × 4 feet and may be seasonal. So that they may dry up during the summer. This helps in the eradication of unwanted vegetation, fungi, bacteria and many fish enemies and increasing the productivity. Young fry about 3 to 5 days old are transformed from spawning pond to the nursery pond, where they remain for about 30 days. The main objective of constructing the nursery is to create the suitable condition of food availability. Their number may be up to 4. That is the third type of the pond is called a nursery pond. This is also called a transplantation pond. This main objective of the constructing nursery is to create the suitable condition of the food availability, and their number may be up to 4. And last type of the pond is called a rearing pond. Such ponds may be seasonal or perennial. Seasonal means they are used only season, or perennial means they are used all the season. Their size is also 90 × 30 × 4 feet in size and are used for rearing advanced fry for the 2 to 3 months. These ponds made long and narrow, gently sloping to facilitate netting. These ponds are located near the spanning and nursery ponds, and their number may vary depending upon one. They are 2 or 3 year rotation of the carp culture. Their number may be up to 12. So these are the more construction ponds of the rearing. They are up to 12. And last pond is called a stocking pond. These are the fairly large perennial ponds. They are used in any season. They are also more about 6 feet deep. Their size may be 300 × 88 × 6. That is their length, weight, breadth, height, feet, and are so constructed that it may be facilitated the netting. Beside the, these are the stocking pond. So generally, in the layout or the fish pond design, we see the 5 types of the ponds we are constructed. That is the head pond, second is the hatching pits or hatching happa ponds, third is the nursery pond, fourth is the rearing pond, and fifth is the stocking pond. Beside the aforementioned ponds, a fish farm may also have the quarantine ponds for the treatment of fishes, marketing pond, cypriner or salmonid pond, etc. The size of various ponds mentioned in the text are for the fish farm having the 5-acre area. A complete fish farm designing has been shown in the figure. In this figure, we see these different type of the pond. A is mentioned, that is the breeding pond. V figure is indicate hatching pits. C indicate nursery pond. D indicate rearing pond. E indicate stocking pond. And F is the marketing pond. So thus in the today we learn about the fish farm engineering as related. The first is the water supply and second is the layout or the design of the fish pond. Next period, we see the next topic. Yes, goodbye, the student.